Our next speaker is Dr. Alex Passion. He's from Rotterdam, the Netherlands, and he's a director from Crystal Touch Clinics, and he will be talking about the origin of synkinesis, the most common complication. Palsy is, in fact, reversible. Thank you.
Good afternoon. Oops, two microphones at the same time, I believe. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. We're a very small clinic, private clinic in Rotterdam, and we found our research all by ourselves. And all the pictures that I included in this presentation are of our patients, and of course we have their written permission for unlimited, unrestricted use. This is our disclosure, not much to disclose. I'm one of the owners and active specialists of the clinic. Human face, the most sophisticated communication tool that has ever existed. Perfected for its purpose by millions of years of evolution. We need this tool every day to interact with other humans. When Bell's palsy happens, the patients lose their ability for both volitional and emotional control of their mimics. What this also means that they lose their ability for non-verbal communication. If full spontaneous recovery does not happen within 3 to 6 weeks, then it is almost certain that patients later will be confronted with the various complications and residuals. Synkinesis is by far the most devastating complication of long-standing Bell's palsy. It has a dramatic effect on the quality of life. It may lead to loss of self-esteem, loss of self-confidence. Sometimes it results in social isolation. Usually synkinesis begins to manifest itself within 3 to 4 months since the onset of Bell's palsy. During the last 5 years at Crystal Touch Clinic in Rotterdam, we have been busy studying complications and residuals of long-standing Bell's palsy. After analyzing the data of over 300 patients, we have come to the following conclusions. Facial synkinesis is a conditioned reflex. Facial synkinesis is a conditioned reflex. A conditioned reflex that involves the volitional mimetic center of our brain. At the moment, there are 3 major hypotheses about the possible causes for facial synkinesis. The most widely accepted one is the concept of aberrant nerve regeneration. All 3 concepts presume that facial synkinesis is an organic and thus irreversible result of certain random processes happening during the regeneration of the facial nerve. However, random processes, per definition, should lead every time to a different and not correlated result. Yet, synkinesis amazingly show amazing similarity in their patterns and correlation. For example, this lady here above is Sharon. You have seen her at the poster just outside this room and maybe have read her story. She's coming to our clinic from Vancouver Island in Canada. Lady here below is Gabriela from Brazil. She's a TV reporter, also coming to our clinic for her working sessions. You can see that when they are trying to smile, but one side of the face is showing a natural pattern, and the other face, other side of the face is showing very similar mechanics, very similar modal, very similar correlation pattern. So, by definition, this leads to different, should lead to different results, but it does not. So this was the starting point of our research. During the early stages of Bell's palsy recovery, nothing moves on the affected side. No smiling, no blinking, no facial reflection of emotions. And the patient exerts very intensive mental efforts trying to produce anything on the affected side of the face. Resulting excitation spreads through the whole facial area of motor cortex. And massive excitation of motor cortex leads to a massive stream of efferent signals in the direction of facial muscles. Yet, there is still no movement, and respectively, no proprioceptive feedback from the muscles back to the brain, because the facial nerve is still regenerating. As regeneration progresses, facial muscles begin to respond to mimetic signals. We do remember that those contraction signals still have a very high intensity. Thanks to positive proprioceptive feedback and constant repetition, this massive stream of efferent signals gradually transforms into a conditioned reflex. When the first signs of synkinesis appear, the patients do not realize anymore that they are now subconsciously exerting excessive efforts, much more than necessary to produce mimetic movements. This has already become their dominant mimetic behavior. And this subconscious mimetic amplifier goes on each time when an individual is trying to produce facial movements, reflective, volitional, or emotional. Facial muscles that take the longest time to recover usually become what we call masters of synkinetic patterns. For example, if musculus orbicularis oculi is recovering slower than musculi zygomatici, then the former becomes a master of ocular oral synkinesis. Musculi zygomatici then very likely to become slaves in this synkinetic pattern. We have implemented this master-slave concept in our method, instrumental method of measurements, which is called synkinetic correlation. We have presented this method during the last European Congress for NeuroRehabilitation in December last year in Vienna. The good news is that, as any other conditioned reflex, facial synkinesis can be successfully reversed by negative feedback. How to do it? We teach our patients during working sessions in our clinic in Rotterdam. Our method of neuroproprioceptive facial rehabilitation we have also presented in 2014 during the last previous World Congress for Neurorehabilitation in Istanbul. Of course, the concept of facial synkinesis being a result of being a conditioned reflex needs to be further developed. More research in this direction is very welcome. But even now, in this very moment, I do believe that the most important conclusion of our research so far, and of this short presentation in particular, is for the estimated 12 million long-standing Bell's palsy sufferers in the world, there is now new hope. There is now the way to reverse their synkinesis, to restore their facial symmetry, and to finally, finally bring back their long lost smiles. We will discuss Bell's palsy, its causes, recovery, complications, and modern methods of the recovery during a special Bell's Palsy Information Day here in Philadelphia. We have organized this free event for the long-standing Bell's palsy sufferers from US and Canada. All of you are most welcome to join us this coming Saturday here in Marriott Downtown Hotel at 11 o'clock in room 401. All of you are most welcome. If you have questions, need more details, or need a car, I will be outside after this session. Thank you very much.